Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today's topic of my video is Edmund Spenser. Edmund Spenser is the greatest Elizabethan poet. His lifespan is from 1552 to 1599. Edmund Spenser is called Poet's Poet by Charles Lamb. He is called Poet's Poet by Charles Lamb because he wrote poetry of very high quality. And other poets also think him and consider him as the greatest poet of his times. Some of the important works of Edmund Spenser in chronological order are The Shepherdess Calendar, The Fairy Queen, Amority and Epithalmium, Prothalmium, Estrophel, and Colin Clout Come Home Again. These are some of his major works in chronological order. And let's study all these works one by one. His first important work is The Fairy Queen. The Fairy Queen was published in 1590 and it was an incomplete epic poem. This Fairy Queen was intended to be completed in 12 books. 12 books were planned earlier, but only 6 books were completed. And 7th book is incomplete. 1st, 2nd and 3rd book, they were published in 1590. And 4th, 5th and 6th book, they were published in 1596. So these two dates are important. In 1590, first 3 books were published and next 3 books were published in 1596. In The Fairy Queen, the Spenserian verse or the Spenserian stanza was first introduced by Edmund Spenser. Now, what is Spenserian stanza? Spenserian stanza is 9-line stanza. 8 lines are written in iambic pentameter and the last line is written in iambic hexameter or single alexandrine. First 8 lines, iambic pentameter. Last line, iambic hexameter. The rhyming scheme of Spenserian stanza is ABAB, BCBC and C. ABAB, BCBC and C. This Fairy Queen is written in praise of Elizabeth I and it celebrates Tudor dynasty. It is an allegorical poem. King Arthur is the hero of Fairy Queen and Gloriana is the heroine of Fairy Queen. This Gloriana represents Queen Elizabeth I. And at the end of the poem, Prince Arthur married Gloriana. So this is allegorical poem and one of the longest poems. 12 knights in Fairy Queen represents 12 virtues. Now let's see preface to the Fairy Queen. The preface to the Fairy Queen was also published in 1590. In this, a letter was written by Edmund Spenser to Sir Walter Raleigh. And in this letter, the Spenser disclosed that he is going to write a poem in 12 books. Though he was not able to complete 12 books, only 6 books were completed. And in this letter only, he disclosed to Sir Walter Raleigh that he will complete of the Fairy Queen in 12 books. So we come to know from this letter that it was intended, this Fairy Queen was intended to be completed in 12 books, but only 6 books were completed. So this is incomplete epic poem by Edmund Spenser. The Spenser mottos in writing the epic is to fashion a gentleman in virtuous and gentle discipline. Next important work of Edmund Spenser is Amority. Amority is the sonnet sequence. In this, there are 89 sonnet sequences. Amority, in Amority, he addresses to Elizabeth Boyle, his wife. Amority was first published in 1595 and it is based on Petrarchan model of love. In Petrarchan model of love, the lover or the bridegroom is compared to heavenly objects, is compared to goddess. So in this Amoretti also, Edmund Spenser has compared Elizabeth Boyle to goddesses and heavenly objects. So Amoretti is very important sonnet sequence of Edmund Spenser. Next important work is Epithalmion. Epithalmion and Amoretti, they were in the same book. In the same book, Amoretti and Epithalmion was written, and the complete title is Amoretti and Epithalmion, written not long by Edmund Spenser. And this is the title. Epithalmion, in Epithalmion, he celebrates his own nuptial song with Elizabeth Boyle. He celebrates his marriage with Elizabeth Boyle in Epithalmion. He describes the wedding day itself. He also celebrates sexual union of married couple. So this Epithalmion is erotic. In this poem, there are 24 stanzas which represents number of hours and 365 lines which represents number of days. So Epithalmion is very important work by Edmund Spenser, in which he celebrates his own marriage with Elizabeth Boyle. His next important work is Prothalmion. Complete title, Prothalmion or Spousal Verse in Honor of the Double Marriage of Lady Elizabeth and Lady Catherine Somerset. Prothalmion is also nuptial song. Like Epithalmion, Epithalmion was also nuptial song, but it was his own nuptial song. But Prothalmion is the nuptial song of twin sisters, of two sisters, Elizabeth and Catherine Somerset. This Prothalmion was composed on the occasion of twin marriage of the daughter of Earl of Worcester, Elizabeth Somerset and Catherine Somerset. And this is non-erotic poem, unlike Epithalmion. His next important work is Schafer's Calendar. Schafer's Calendar was his first major poetic work, which was published in 1579. This Schafer's Calendar was dedicated to his friend Sidney. It was dedicated to Sir Philip Sidney. And it was published under pseudonym Immeritu. The theme of Schafer's Calendar is unrequited love of Colin Cloud for Rosalind. Schafer's Calendar is based on eclogues by Virgil. It depicts the life of Schafer through 12 months of year. So there are 12 books in Schafer's Calendar. Schafer's Calendar is a series of pastoral eclogue for every month in a year. He also wrote Mother Hubert's Tale. Mother Hubert's Tale is the satire by Edmund Spenser. It is satire to denounce the neglect of arts and letters. His next work, Colin Clout, Come Home Again, describes his stay in London. Some of the quotes related to Edmund Spenser are, Spenser writ no language. These words were said by Ben Jonson. Spenser writ no language. Ben Jonson about Edmund Spenser. Also, Spenser is called poet by Charles Lamb. And one important thing, Schafer's Calendar was written by Edmund Spenser in 1579. This is a poem. And Schafer's Calendar is again a poem by John Clare, which was published in 1827. So this is all about Edmund Spenser. Friends, if you like my video, then please like my video. And don't forget to subscribe my button. Thank you.